Hi, today we will take a look at the improper fractions. But first, we need to remember that in a fraction like this one, the top number is a numerator and the bottom number is a denominator. Once again, the top number is a numerator and the bottom number is a denominator. Nice! In a previous lesson, we studied the proper fraction. It's a fraction whose numerator, the top number, is less than its denominator, the bottom number. For example, the fraction 1 half is a proper fraction because the numerator 1 is less than the denominator 2. You got it? Now we're going to focus on the improper fraction. It's a fraction whose numerator is greater than or equal to its denominator. For example, 2 halves is an improper fraction given that the numerator 2 is equal to the denominator, also 2. Finally, the fraction 3 halves is another improper fraction because the numerator 3 is greater than the denominator 2. Let's continue with more examples. Once again, an improper fraction is a fraction whose numerator is greater than or equal to its denominator. One more example. The fraction 7/4 is an improper fraction, given that the numerator 7 is greater than the denominator 4. Finally, the fraction 8/8 is also an improper fraction. The numerator 8 is equal to the denominator 8. And now it is time to solve an exercise. Pay attention to the following image. How many blueberry pies do we have over here? To get the answer, we're going to focus on one slice of the first pie. Now, what fraction of the pie would this slice represent? Well, we have divided this pie into 3 equal parts, into 3 equal slices. And we took one of those parts, one of those slices. Yes, we took one of 3 equal parts. Therefore, this slice represents 1/3 of the pie. The next slice also represents 1/3 of the pie, and the next one also represents 1/3 of the pie. The same story with the second pie. We have 1/3, 1/3, and 1/3 of the pie. However, we won't consider the last slice, given that I already ate it. And now, how many blueberry pies do we have over here? We have 1/3, 2/3, 3/3, 4/3, and 5/3. That's it, we have 5/3 pies. As you might notice, 5/3 is an improper fraction, given that the numerator 5 is greater than the denominator 3. But there is something else. Let's go back to the first pie. As you can see, we took this pie completely. We can put the pieces together. Here we have one whole pie or one whole, but we also have a little of the second pie. So we have one whole and a little more. We have more than one whole. Therefore, our improper fraction 5/3 is greater than one whole. Yes, and this is related to another characteristic of the improper fractions. An improper fraction is greater than or equal to 1. Once again, an improper fraction is greater than or equal to 1 whole. Finally, I gotta tell you that an improper fraction can be written as a mixed number or a whole number. In this case, we're going to rewrite our improper fraction 5/3 as a mixed number. So let's go back to the first pie one more time. And as I told you before, we took this pie completely. We took one whole pie, we took one whole. But we also have a little of the second pie. What fraction of the second pie do we have over here? Well, we have 1/3 and 2/3. That's right, we have one whole and 2/3. Come over here, please. In that way, our improper fraction 5/3 is equal to the mixed number 1 and 2/3. Don't forget that a mixed number contains a whole number and a fraction. Yes, a mixed number contains a whole number and a fraction. Let's continue with another example. And guess what? The next example is also about food. How many apple pies are over there? To get the answer, we need to focus on one slice of the first pie. What fraction of the pie would this slice represent? Well, this pie has been divided into 5 equal parts, into 5 equal slices. And we took one of those parts. That's right, we took one of 5 equal parts. Therefore, this slice represents 1/5 of the pie. The next slice also represents 1/5 of the pie. 1/5 over here, 1/5 over here, 1/5 over there. In the second pie, we also have 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, and 1/5. The same story with the third pie. However, we won't consider the last two slices because someone already ate them. And now, how many apple pies do we have? Well, we have 1/5, 2/5, 3/5, 4/5, 5/5, 6/5, 7/5, 8/5, 9/5, 10/5, 11/5, 12/5, and 13/5. Yes, we have 13/5 pies. Perfect! As you might notice, 13/5 is an improper fraction, given that the numerator 13 is greater than the denominator 5. Finally, remember that an improper fraction can be written as a mixed number or a whole number. So now we're going to rewrite our improper fraction 13 fifths as a mixed number. Let's go back to the first two pies. As you can see, we took these two pies completely. Yes, we have one and two whole pies, two wholes. And we also have a little of the third pie. What fraction of the third pie do we have over here? Well, we have 1/5, 2/5, and 3/5. That is right, we have 2 wholes and 3 fifths. Come over here, please. In that way, our improper fraction 13 fifths is equal to the mixed number 2 and 3 fifths. Don't forget that a mixed number contains a whole number and a fraction. Once again, a mixed number contains a whole number and a fraction. We are done with this problem. Now pay attention to the following exercise. How many oranges are in the image? Please write the answer as an improper fraction and also as a mixed number. And don't forget to leave your answer in the comments. On this site, you will find more lessons about improper fractions and mixed numbers. And over here, more videos. That's all for today. See you next lesson. Bye!